girls. I'm so glad to be with you today. I've missed all of you, and I'm hoping you're all very safe at home and having a good time just being with your families. And I'm just thankful that I can be with you today. And let's get started with our Bible story today. Our Bible story comes from the book of Luke, and we know that everything in the Bible is what? True, right? And we can stand on God's word and God's promises and know that he is always with us and that he's taking care of each one of us. So today I'd like to read you a story about the boy who went away, or the prodigal son. And this is it's Luke 15, 11 through 24. And here we go. A big boy lived with his brother and his daddy, and the big boy was not happy. Can you give me an unhappy face? He didn't want his daddy to tell him what to do. So one day, the big boy took all his pennies and said, "Goodbye." Then he went far away down the road, and he left his home. And he was happy about it. Now his daddy couldn't tell him what to do anymore. Nobody told him what to do, and he was very happy about that. Nobody said, "Eat your carrots," or "Don't do that," or "It's time to go to bed." The big boy did just what he wanted to do every day. He took his pennies to the store. He bought just what he wanted. He had lots of fun until one day. What would you buy if you could go to the store with all of your pennies? Would you use it all up at once or save some of your pennies? I don't know, but this boy, he had lots of fun until one day his pennies were all gone. "I know what to do," the big boy said. "I'll go to work, and then I'll get more pennies. I have a great idea." So he set out. He went to work. He took care of a man's pigs. But he never got enough pennies, and he was very hungry every day. Did you see? He's all dirty, and it's a big job to take care of all those pigs and feed them. You have to get in there with the pigs and feed them the slop. At last, the big boy thought, "The man who worked for my daddy, they have lots to eat. I'll go to my daddy. I'll go home and see him. I'll say to him, 'Daddy, I've been bad. I haven't pleased God. I haven't pleased you, and I'm very sorry.'" He looks sorry, doesn't he? So the big boy started walking. Step, step, step. Can you pretend like you're walking down the road and you're going back home to see your dad? Went his feet. Step, 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 all the way home. His daddy saw him coming. His daddy ran and put his arms around him and gave him a kiss and gave him the biggest hug ever. He was so excited to see his son. "Daddy," said the big boy, "I've been bad. I haven't pleased God. I haven't pleased you. And I'm very sorry." His dad gave him a big hug, didn't he? His daddy wasn't angry. Oh no, his daddy said, "Quick, bring me some new clothes for my son." Because he had very dirty clothes on, didn't he? He needed to change them. "Bring him some shoes. Bring him a ring. My boy has come home. Let's have a big dinner party." And they all did. They were so excited to have him home. What did you learn from the story? When the boy came home, was his daddy glad? He was very glad to see him. Just like your Heavenly Father is glad sometimes when we do things and we go away and we don't do what God wants us to do. He's so glad when we come back to him. He loves us. When we just tell him we're sorry, he forgives us and he loves us so much. So I have a little way that you can retell your story at home. If you want to try this, you could set up a little area where you could put some money out and an empty box, and then a place where there's a little pig pen and a rope on a chair. And we'll start here. As we retell the story about the little boy who took all of his pennies, he put them into his bag. And he said, what did he say? He said, goodbye, I'm leaving, I'm going away. And he took his money and he went down the road. And as he got there, what did he do? He spent all of his money. He did whatever he wanted to do. And he said, oh, I'd like to buy this. I'm gonna buy this. I'm gonna buy some candy. I'm gonna buy all this good stuff, whatever I want. And then he took his, finally, one day, there was nothing left. He had used all of his money. It was empty. There's nothing in it anymore. He had nothing in his bag, nothing in his box to spend anymore. So he went down the road and he said, I know, I'm going to get a job. So he went down in the road and he said, could I have a job, sir? I need some more pennies. So he got into his pig pen and he fed the pigs and slopped them and gave them food. He got really dirty and it was really hard work, but he never got enough pennies. So he said, I know, I have an idea. I have to go home to my father because I have nothing else. So he said, I need to tell my dad that I'm sorry and that I've been bad and that I love him and that I'm sorry that I did what I've done. So he went home. And his dad was so glad to see him. He put his arms around him and he loved him. And he said, oh, I'm so glad you're home, son. He said, quick, let's have a party. Let's give him a robe. Let's give him a ring. So they put a robe on him and they gave him a ring and they had a big dinner party. And they were so happy to see each other. And that is the end of the story of the prodigal son. And I'd just like to go over our memory verse for the month, too. And it was, with God, all things are possible. Matthew 19:26. So remember, boys and girls, that with God, everything is possible. And that's a good verse for the times we're going through right now. With God, everything is possible. I hope you all have a very nice day, and it was good to be with you. I'll see you.